successful. I'm sure they were chasing after something. I did hear crashing through the bush. But it doesn't look like they've been successful, unfortunately. I do have to sit in complete darkness, because if you shine light on the lions, it shows them up to the prey. And if you shine a light on the prey, it blinds the prey so that they may be more likely to be taken down by the lions, but it is an unfair advantage that you give to the lions. And also, to try and keep the animals relaxed, we do have a rule of only one spotlight on the animals. We were eyeing up a giraffe a little bit earlier, just as we were leaving. We heard someone say that the giraffe was from the area that we saw. But obviously they weren't successful with that either. What I'd love right now, we've got the sounds of the bush, and just to finish it off would be the lions calling. I've heard something moving. Amazing, lines have become extremely different cats once the sun sets. Remember, eyesight is 6 times better than our eyesight. Their hearing is much better, and their sense of smell also. They really are predators of the night. And under the cover of darkness, it's almost as if they become even bolder. And this is exactly the same spot as we left Karula. Hi Christy, welcome on board this evening. And it's very difficult for me to say exactly the success rate of a lion hunt, but it's very slim. If you get the statistic that's in the past. Big branch. Something going around the other side. In the long grass, the branch is getting hidden even more in the dark. Making sure that we're not shining in her eyes. One way to annoy a lion. but I'm trying to remember that statistic, Christy, of the success rate, and I think it's somewhere in its 40s. I think it's like 40% success rate. So I've seen many lions start to hunt and go through the motions of hunting, but I've only ever seen 2 kills in my life, and 3, including the one we caught Wada at Wild Earth at Gowrie Dam, and I think many of you may have remembered that. We managed to catch it on the Gowrie Dam camera. But in the 5 years of guiding, I've only ever seen 2 kills. The buffalo kill from the same pride that we're watching now, and a wildebeest that got taken down by the pride on the old reserve. And that happened in complete darkness. I had to switch off everything because there was a lioness sitting in front of me, and I suddenly realised that the other two had disappeared. And I suddenly realised they were hunting, so I switched off all the lights, and we were sat a good 10-15 metres from her, and we could hear the hoofbeats of the wildebeest, which I'm sure I heard just before we went live right now. So I think there was some wildebeest here, or something, a hoofed mammal that they were after. And then we just heard the hoofbeats in the darkness, and the next moment we just hear the thud, and that's when I could switch on the light, and there was a lioness with her death grip around the wildebeest. It was very quick, very sudden. Quite amazing. A lot of you are asking about the infrared light. Unfortunately, we don't have at the moment. We'd love to be able to film with the infrared light, and that allows us to see in the dark and not have to have the spotlight shining and showing up these animals, especially during hunting. And we have been able to use it in the past. We did have one with the smaller camera we used to use. At the moment, the other one, the infrared light that we did have, we're not able to use. See if I can pull a bit closer after this vehicle leaves. It looks like they're settling in again.
2, 4, 3.
Thanks, Ryan.
Hello,
we didn't talk you there. I was just saying thanks.
Thanks very much, sir.
You too. I thought we were lucky then.
Sorry, go ahead.
I thought we were lucky with a Bamba then. Copy. Okay, it's far enough away. We'll see if we can move forward without disturbing them. Trying to do with the spotlight is not to shine in the eyes and just bounce it off the vegetation so we can still see them, but it's not going to hurt the eyes. It doesn't look like they're going to become vocal anytime soon, sadly. And they do call. Territorial marking. The females also have a territory wherever they are in the home range, they'll defend that. The territory of the males also be defended. And I'm just wondering if they've heard some more lions calling. And if they're a strong pride, they will call back. The nights are just alive with the sounds of the crickets, and the cicadas. It really is amazing. So if you can imagine, there's a beautiful sky of stars. Orion is right above our heads, the crescent moon behind us. And even Venus, just above the moon. A wonderful night to be out in Africa. The lions can spend 20 hours a day sleeping. When they're walking, they can cover many kilometers. And I think these ladies are hungry. They may move on at some stage. They have rested all day. They may wait to see if there's something else that's going to come through. They're going to preserve the energy. Apparently, they last hunted around Tuesday or Wednesday. And when a big male lion eats, he can eat 50 kilos in one go, in one sitting. They need an average a day of about 7 kilos of food, so that meal can last them for quite a while. Their bellies don't look extremely thin, but they do look like they could do with a meal now. They may only catch something in the next couple of days. There you go, complete contentment at the moment. Well, I think now is probably a good time to say goodbye. Looks like they've settled in for a short while. It could be a couple of hours before they move again. But thank you very much for joining us, and I hope you've enjoyed seeing their sights into what they do at night as well. And it could have been that they could have made a kill. I'm sure I heard something, I'm sure they did try, but unfortunately they weren't successful. But it is just such a privilege to be here and be able to share this to you, and I really hope you have enjoyed it as much as we have. We've certainly shared a lot of ahs and oohs and certainly a few wonderful moments there. So thank you very much for joining us here on Wild Earth, and I hope you can catch us again on safari soon. Take care from myself and the crew. Goodbye for now.